I think it's useless to heal the symptoms if we don't heal consciousness. The central issue is heal the degradation of consciousness. It's like undoing the fall of man, the legendary fall of man, the degradation of the mind. I don't think that can be done massively, but one can prevent the fall if we created a form of education specifically for that. If we educated people for consciousness and not for reduction, and not for socialization, not for adaptation to a society. The question is, who wants that?
Mm-hmm.
Is there a political will? Could we conceive political agreement that we're going to pull our resources together globally to have a new education that takes care of consciousness? I think unlikely is that it is that an assassin can kill itself.
Mm-hmm.
Like the system can get out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
It's possible that the great danger may bring sufficiently intelligent people to that conclusion. It's better for a global future that we give priority to the real thing that has priority, which is the mind. Yes. I don't know about the likelihood. I think I have some intuition that it may not be so impossible because the system where we have constructed, the civilization we have constructed, is crumbling down. It comes to such critical state that it loses power. The delegitimation. The people are not legitimizing the people who govern them, who are not seen as representative. And we are seeing the great hoax of economy and the money system. The common people are discovering that it's all a lie and a kind of collective crime. So certain truths are being perceived by the multitudes. And that may allow the community to create something new.
Okay.
From that, if people take education, people begin to own education, take it away from the authorities. In a time when the authorities cannot cope with feeding the schools or feeding, so supporting all that bureaucracy of education, it could happen like a snake that leaves its old skin behind.
My second book is about, the title is The Return of the Shamanic Consciousness, and it's talking about this topic also. And when I saw the Indians, or even the modern people of Nepal or so, they got a lot of more of it than we in the West got. I guess they spent maybe 40% of the day for working and stuff like that, and the rest of the time they have a lot of social contacts. They feed each other. That in the jungle, the Indians, they talk to each other, and they got body contact, and they hold each other in the arms and sitting around and just watching the birds or the trees. And it's I think it's a lot of this what is missing in our culture. What is your idea? How to get it in a broad broad way to the people, because we there are so many people now, and in Germany we would need millions of therapists to get this to the people.
No, it cannot be done. I think that's why I think of education. Everybody goes through school or through nursing or educating the families for a different attitude. psychotherapy, I think, has to limit itself to helping prepare people, prepare teachers, prepare.
Yeah. But in Germany, there's, especially in Germany, I don't know how it is in the other countries in Europe or in America, there's a paradigm that you don't, you cannot combine therapy or therapy methods with education.
It's very bad.
And it's also, the thinking is also in the universities, where the teachers are taught how to be a teacher. And in this state of mind, they go out to teach the children, and this
yes,
is a
yes.
big
you
problem.
You were talking about my idea of an age of synthesis.
Yeah.
Education
yeah.
is an exception.
Yeah.
There should be a synthesis in which education brings in the spiritual knowledge and brings in the therapeutic knowledge. But education has succeeded in being the most conservative of institutions. Everything changes, everything, there's progress, but education stays the same at heart.
Yeah.
They may have computers, but
yeah.
the same narrow spirit.
It even gets more, I think, somehow it even gets more ridiculous.
The non-seekers are getting stronger, to
yeah.
anti-seekers.
Yes.
Conservative.
Conservative,
yes. Conservative is dominating the world.
Yeah. Yeah.
But perhaps it's everything is becoming so much against the wall that mm-hmm. we don't have to fight conservatism because nature is fighting it. Nature will.
Yeah.
Make it fail.
Yeah, I think so.
That's a hope.
Could be, yes.
We don't need a revolution like
yeah,
the Marxists expected.
Yes.
To the enemies of humanity.
Yeah.
It's like in the joke that I tell about the ego, that it falls by itself.
Yeah.
After you understand your own idiocy, it goes. You don't have to fight it.
yeah.
It falls by itself, and the social system maybe is sinking like an old ship that sinks.
Mm-hmm.
And so those who abandon the ship and go to the lifeboats,
mm-hmm.
those will be the creative founders of a new society.
Yeah, the Indians of Northern America, the plains, I guess they said they have a myth that one day the volcanoes will explode again, and that the parish that the white man spread all the world will wash away.
It's happening a little bit, huh?
Mm.
Many coincidences.
Yes.
Of disasters of large
yeah.
scale.
Yeah. You see in Fukushima.
Hmm?
Fukushima, for example.
Yes,
yeah.
yes.
Yeah. Okay. And your idea is to get this to the teachers, and the teachers teach the scholars, and from this it could be get a broader base.
Maybe the conservative teachers will have to be replaced by people who have had a personal development.
Yes.
Maybe there will be a place for the seekers, who are the marginal people.
Yeah.
Will go. Well, the system will need them.
Yes.
For consciousness help.
And you also, you already did such trainings, I guess, in Italy.
In Spain, in Chile, in Mexico, in different places.
Yes.
To a limited extent.
Yeah.
I'm not very satisfied with the extent to which the system has opened up in the universities.
Mm.
They have their curricula, and everybody has a place that each person thinks he has the most precious thing to teach, and there's a difficulty in creating room for something new.
Yeah.
And in the schools it's even more impermeable, more difficult to change curriculum.
Okay.
And even if curricula changed, it's not, you need a human transmission.
Yeah.
It's not just, it cannot be done by the book.
Yeah.
It has to do with the transformation of teachers. With it. So I thought the program I have going, it's so powerful that people have such transformation in a short time.
Of course, yeah.
This applied to teachers,
yeah,
would create the kind of teachers we need.
Yes, of course.
But the universities have not bought it, the schools have not bought it.
Yeah.
So I've decided I did my best, I did my job, I put out my product. Now it's my time to do something else.
Okay, good. Thank you for the interview.